It was done in the name of science more than a century ago. The Smithsonian Museum of Natural History, as it's now called, collected more than 250 brains.
The brain collection specifically was started by Alice Herdlichka. He was a physical anthropologist that led the Department of Physical Anthropology at the Smithsonian. He really was fixated on the belief that you can tell differences between people by looking at their brains or body parts.
Those brains included those harvested from Filipinos sent to St. Louis for the 1904 World's Fair as part of a human zoo.
It wasn't just one sect of Filipinos, right? It was a range of Filipinos, whether it's, you know, Visayans or Igorots. It was a range of different types of Filipinos who were put on display and treated as savages.
One of them was named Maura, a Filipina who died before the fair even started. Virtually nothing was done with those brains, no significant research at all, and that collection might have been forgotten, except for the investigation conducted by the Washington Post. It wasn't just an article in the paper, but also a video and a Sunday insert, an insert that presented the story as a graphic novel in both English and Tagalog, the first time the Post has ever published content in the Filipino language.
To see your history, not just told in English, but to be told in your language, is also to be seen. It's to be heard. It's an opportunity for the young Filipinos, as well as the older Filipinos, to absorb the story together.
A story that is resulting in more than just awareness.
The Secretary of the Smithsonian announced that he was creating a task force, a human remains task force, to address all of the remains in their collection. They have over 30,700 sets of remains, including the brains.
To be able to see the Smithsonian taking active steps to return some of these remains to families and also to countries, I think has been really heartening for us.
And hopefully bringing closure to this dark chapter in U.S. history. Mary Estacion, ABS-CBN News, Washington, D.C.